Hello, what's up, America? This is old Jim Bob from Jim Bob's Commentary Channel, coming to you from a secret location somewhere in America. Well, today I thought I'd do a little commentary for you fellas out there about to get into a relationship with a woman, especially you young fellas of inexperience like myself. You need to have a little guidance and know what to expect, you see. Love is a wonderful thing and all that stuff, and it all turns out good in the end, but you got to be prepared for the sudden shocks and changes in your life. Especially if you're a feller who has your own place, you know, you have your own house or apartment or something like that, and your girlfriend's coming to live with you. You got to be prepared for some changes that are going to come along that you're not going to expect. So I thought that I would just fill you in on that so you'd have a heads up when it happens, okay? So here's what you got to do. Now, I'm not saying don't be in love with your girlfriend or nothing like that. Go on and do that. It's all a good thing. In the end, it'll be all right. So here you go. The first thing is, and you know, everybody's always heard about this, but if you got your own place and you've been living in it a long time and you've got your furniture arranged the way you got it arranged and stuff like that, when she comes to visit, everything will stay the same, but boy, when she moves in, you better be prepared to change things because it's going to change big time. And the first thing is, everybody said it's about the toilet seat, see? Now, it's always been a baffling to me about the whole situation on the toilet seat. A fella goes in the bathroom and lifts up a lid and he takes a leak. And he flushes the toilet and he goes on about his business. Okay. Well, somehow or another, women, I don't guess they go to the bathroom during the daytime. I don't know what it is, but they'll go in there in the middle of the night and sit down there and then they'll get the butt wet. Now, I don't understand that. When I go in the bathroom in the nighttime, I turn the light on and look down in there and see if there's a snake or something in there. I mean, it's because I've been out in the woods. See, when you're in the woods, you better look before you turn around and turn your butt down to something or other. Anyhow, somehow or another, they get the butt wet, and then that there's the problem. So that's the first thing you're going to have to get readjusted to. And then there's a different type of a toilet seat situation. That's the fella that don't raise the lid. And, you know, inevitably a little dribble or two will get on the lid. And, you know, ain't no big deal. But apparently to women it is a big deal and stuff like that. Well, my defense to that is, there have been several studies that shown that when you turn around and face the toilet and flush it, you're getting all kind of spew all over you from everything. So it ain't no different than a couple of drops on the toilet seat. So get over it. Anyway, well, okay, but you're going to have to change it because, I mean, you're in love now, see. Now, that's just the tip of the iceberg. I mean, that ain't worth it. It's going to cost you money. I'm talking about get your credit card out, get you some loans going and stuff like that because things are going to change in your house. Now, you know how you went out and you shot that there 8-point buck and you put him up on the wall and you shot that big old hog and you got him mounted up there on the wall and so on and the bear and stuff like that. Well, all that's got to go. And that's going out in the garage and you're going to have some other different stuff. And the colors on the wall, that ain't going to do. They're all going to have to change. So you're going to be spending a lot of time over at Lowe's or Home Depot getting paint and stuff like that to paint all that. Well, that's just a part of it. That part, you know, I think I could put up with. It don't bother me so much. The thing that bothers me the most, though, is the TV. See, I have my chair set up, I mean, straight on the TV. I see, that's the way I like it. I look straight on at it. And I've been involved with three women now. Caroline, she's probably the best of the lot so far. I really like her. She's the most cooperative anyhow. But them other two, it doesn't matter. First one, she was a great one, Loretta. She was a good woman. The second one, I ain't even gonna mention her name. Anyhow, the first two of them, they don't like TVs or something or another because no matter how that house got decorated, that TV was on a right angle or a left angle. I mean, you couldn't, and I get a crick in my neck trying to watch the TV. And I keep telling them, just let me line up my chair with the TV. And so I can see it without getting a crick in my neck. And then, and some of them, it takes a recliner, don't want no recliner in the house at all, and get rid of that. And you have to sit on a couch. You got no choice about it. I don't care nothing about that kind of stuff. Anyhow, that's some of the stuff. So get ready. It's going to cost you a lot of money. You're going to have to change your toilet seat habits. You're going to have to paint all the stuff in the house. And oh yeah, you know, the curtains you got, red, white, and blue. You think that matches? No, it don't match no more, buddy. Camouflage is out. All that stuff. Get ready. It's all going to change. Jim Bob's out.